The health department says Metro Manila, Central Luzon, and Central Visayas were the regions that tallied the most number of dengue cases in June. Some 65,000 dengue cases were reported from January 1st to July 2nd. That's an 83% increase from figures recorded in the same period last year. The rise in dengue cases has prompted several provinces, including Antique, to declare a state of calamity.
In terms of the admissions hospital, no, hindi naman po ganun kapuno yung hospital no for dengue cases kasi nga minimal kasi nga po yung at least na implement po no in the past months na implement po yung early consultation, so hindi po nagla-landing sa hospital yung yung karamihan ng mga pasyente mo. At at average po mo we have a total of 58 no admissions no, per day sa ating mga hospitals po.
A group of private hospitals in the country is confident healthcare facilities will not be overwhelmed by the rise in dengue cases.
In other news, President Marcos raises proposals to address issues on the Philippines' fertilizer supply. In a statement following Monday's meeting with agriculture officials, Marcos says he is willing to pursue government-to-government talks to resolve the matter. He says he could personally write to the governments of China, Indonesia, the United Arab Emirates, Malaysia, and Russia. In late March, the Agriculture Department said it had allotted some 4 billion pesos worth of fertilizer subsidy for farmers amid soaring prices compounded by the rising fuel costs.
An agriculture group urges the Marcos administration to do more than just building farm-to-market roads. The Philippine Chamber of Agriculture and Food Incorporated says the government should develop a more localized food production system to address the logistics issues the sector is currently facing.
Pwede naman po na bawat isla o bawat probinsya ay maging sufficient no sa mga basic na pagkain, no? Especially gulay. Maski saan sa Pilipinas po ay pwede tayong magtanim ng gulay. Hindi naman logical siguro kung yung cabbage ng Panay manggaling pa sa Baguio. Malaking obligasyon no, o responsibility ng ating mga local executives, no? Governor, mayors, na magkaroon talaga ng seryosong programa sa food production, no? Kasi pati itlog, pwede rin yan localize.
As for AGA Party List Representative Nicanor Briones, he's batting for more support for farmers affected by climate-related disasters.
Dahil marami tayong island, siyempre napaka-vulnerable natin sa mga kalamidad, gaya ng bagyo, pagbaha. So ang tingin ko, ang kailangan para ang ating mga farmers ay ma-encourage talaga magtanim, mag-alaga na hayop ng isda, eh kapag may mga ganyang kalamidad, kaagad merong ayuda. At least 50% ng kanilang puhunan ay may balik at na sila ay makabalik.
Metro Manila and many other areas in the Philippines will remain under COVID Alert Level 1, the loosest quarantine restriction until July 31. Meanwhile, over a dozen areas will be under Alert Level 2. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has decided to retain the Alert Level system for now, but he is eyeing to have a new health restriction system in place by next month amid the changes in the pandemic situation in the country. Mild COVID-19 cases have become more common compared to patients experiencing severe symptoms of the disease. Infectious diseases expert Dr. Ron Chinsolante agrees the paradigm shift is necessary.
Born out of the evolving patterns of the cases that we have now. And with this evolution that less people are going to the hospital, more people are getting infected, breakthrough infection is getting more because of the ability of this virus to evade those, even those vaccinated, but less are still getting the severe infection. Then we have to modify that to a point that it's not so disruptive to our mobility.
The health department is also in the process of reorganizing the interagency task force on COVID-19 in line with the Marcos administration's mandate to right-size the bureaucracy.
Here's the latest COVID-19 figures in the country. The health department logged 1,841 infections Tuesday. Over 700 of the new cases are from Metro Manila. The Octo Research Group projects daily COVID cases to still hit the 2,000 mark in the next few days. This, as it notes, an uptick in an infection in parts of the country. country, particularly in Central Luzon and Western Visayas. But OCTA believes the rise in COVID cases in Metro Manila may have already peaked.
Metro Manila may possibility na baka nag-peak na. Paano natin nasabi yan? Kasi pag tinitingnan natin yung daily positivity rate, yung pagkaarawan na bilang ng mga nagpa-positive sa testing, yung pinakamataas ng July 15 at bumaba na ng July 16 at 17. So pinakamataas 14% yung daily positivity rate. Sa NCR pa lang ito. At as of July 17, nasa 12% na lang. So from 14 to 12%. Ang ibig sabihin ito, kung magtuloy-tuloy ito, baka pababa na yung trend natin sa Metro Manila.
OCTA also expects the capital region's healthcare utilization rate to stay below 50% as vaccination coverage improves.